want to do this this morning, I met a young boy. Young man came to our house the other day. It was so thrilling to see him. Knock on their door. Said, I just want to come to you.
So, when was that? Wednesday? parties 2 weeks in my life. We do all this chaos and turmoil and whatever accident or name or whatever it is, whatever you want to use. Through all of this, the greatest thing that's ever happened to me happens Wednesday, and I accept Jesus.
I have a praise report. I wanted to share.
back to the doctor on that Tuesday, and I was expecting to have that place taken off and sent off to see whether or not it was skin cancer. And I met the specialist, and she said, honey, I don't know why she's itchy here, but I think this is fine, but we're just going to keep an eye on it. And if you want to come back in 4 months, we'll take a look at it again. If it's changed, we'll do it. But she just was so, just like, she couldn't believe that I had came at all. And I was just like, thank you, Lord. But He is a healing God. Yeah.
Her food for her. So I've got a menu out here on the bulletin board, and if you can make something for her. for a shower, just sign your name on any dish that's out there. And we just have it a couple weeks, maybe less than 2 weeks, so we need to get that. No, I don't have to call y'all, so just go out there and call us here. And also, we'll be going to Winter Jam, and we leave this Saturday. And we're either going to leave at 10 or 11 o'clock, I'll let you all know. But we will be leaving the church this Saturday to go to Winter Jam.
You'll have to come and see it, it's absolutely beautiful. The flooring is always already down, and all the stuff, the paint walls, they're just, I'm telling you, they're just working. And I really thank Bill and Shirley. Bill is up there, me and Daniel, and they decided days to work, and they're up there working. And I appreciate all of you that are helping. We need painters, we need to get doors cleaning, and all of that done. So if you can do that, we appreciate you helping us all, man. Let's stand today, we'll do our declaration. As we bring in today's tithes, offerings, and over and above giving, we are believing the Lord for a supernatural release of God's favor over every area of our lives. Jobs and better jobs, checks in the mail, inheritances, secure investments, scholarships, creative ideas, finding money, healing for our spirit, soul, and body, deliverance to the captive, salvation to the lost, and an outpouring of the Holy Ghost. We are blessed, and we will be a blessing to others in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I do want to tell you this, that Helen Lawrence is at Tri-City Nursing. I always want to say great name. Sorry. But she is in room 116. And if you can go by and visit her, she would love to see you. We were down there yesterday. And so go by and see her and just pray over her and bless her. And also we would need to pray for Robin Smith's daughter, Brianne. They took her to the hospital, but I think she's out. But she's still not doing feeling real good, so they need prayer. So I ask you to pray for me.
Well, Robin called me last night after the prayer when we went back, and she was scared because her brain had just had a bad burn, and she thought it was blood, and she was paralyzed, she couldn't hardly talk. But she called me back a little before 11, and they had took a couple to the hospital, and everything was fine.
Isaiah 54 and 10 says, for the mountains shall depart, and the hills be removed, but my kindness shall not depart from thee. Neither shall the covenant of my peace be removed from thee, saith the Lord that hath mercy on thee. And in the verses just before that, he was talking about, he says, that my wrath was just for a moment. That this, I hid my face just for a moment, said, but I am your redeemer, that I am not, I will not. He said, I am not mad at you. Said, my love and kindness is not going to leave you. Yeah. It's going to be missing always. So God will be tell you about it. He said, he's not mad at you. Yeah. He is not mad at you. All you got to do is say, your sins have been forgiven. Your sins have been paid for. Jesus Christ has paid for your sins. All you got to do is believe. All you got to do is believe. He says, Romans 10, verse 9, he says, that thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and believe in thine heart that God had raised you from death, you shall be saved. You're going to be saved. But he wanted me to just remind you right now. He said, I'm not mad at you. I'm not mad at you. I love you. My kindness, my love, and my covenant of peace will never leave you. It will never leave you. He loves you. When we pray, remember Brother Tim. But Tim went back to work. Get stronger, his voice is coming back some, and God's good. God is good. Anybody else got a prayer?
Let's pray for my mom. They met her in the hospital last night. I think she might have a gallbladder infection.
Anybody else?
Daniel. Butch is going in the hospital in the morning. He had the clogged artery on the left side. He's dropped out, and they're going to do surgery. And Marcia said, please pray for me.
Damn, I had surgery in 5 hours.
It's just pray this to my wife. It's just pray. God, open that place up. And just keep it open and be able to breathe and things will just work out.
Thank you.
choir witness this morning. We have you all here today. It's good to have Julie and Tim Wings and her family. It's good to have you all with us today in Houston. I wanted to tell you that Trent and Mike, while their head is swelled, they are grandparents. Grand. So I'm telling you, listen, Grant's doing good, John's doing good, beautiful baby, and I'm so glad that everything's over and everybody's doing good. So, but that's why it's good to see Mike here this morning. Good to have him with us. Say something, Mike.
It's good to be here. Thank you for all the prayers and that was congratulations through social media and all that. I really don't know what to say. I'm still trying to process everything that just happened. I may be activated, but Brett gets to be top on the rocks today, and I'm looking forward to that. But you know, God's good.
Yes.
You know, James Harden's and Lashley, man, he was saying we were in school together. It's just exciting to me to see what Jesus is doing. And that he's doing it here in Louisiana,
right.
Korea, California, anybody, anywhere that cry out to the Lord.
That's it.
Yes. Yes. And he's coming to the church first. I believe that. Days are drawing near, he's going to return. And I just know that the Lord is doing something in us so we can lead his prodigals home. Amen. So thank you, guys. God bless you. We love you.
Always good to have Lydia's house here with us, those girls. We're glad to come and worship with us. That means a lot. I tell you, it does. It means a whole lot. I appreciate them. We have to sing happy birthday today. Today's David's birthday. And he has to have yesterday.
It's birthday.
And today's so
birthday on the
8th. And Angel has a birthday on the 8th, so you have to stand too, Angel. So y'all stand. Let's stand. And if you go to 8th, well, Brad, I'm going to call that birthday because I'm going to stand with you.
Anytime.
All right. Anybody else that you haven't sung to and I forgot about you, just stand. We'll sing this morning too. Our boys didn't win yesterday. They got beat by it was like 101-40. But they only had 5 players. Bless their hearts. I believe they
But I have been in the presence of leadership in the morals of very low. Her morals are very low. You're going to get good morals. You're going to get more fucking character. You're going to get some stuff. It's going to be from church, from reading the Bible. It's not going to be from your teacher. It's not going to be from whoever. It's going to, you're going to have to get it yourself. God's doing some stuff in our whole family. He's doing some stuff in our church. And I tell you, if you're going through stuff, please be aware what the devil is trying to do is to get you separated. He's trying to come between husbands and wives. He's trying to come between church members. Keep that unity. The devil works in division. If he gets you divided, you will self-destruct. He don't even have to do anything. You're self-destructing. So keep that relationship firm, strong, together. But again, I want to thank the Lord for what He's done in my family. And I want to thank the Lord for my church when we get to go to. Thank the Lord for this service for the girls back there. I tell you, it's great to come out and be with the Lord, ain't it?
Yes.
This is great.
Yes.
I mean, it don't matter what you're facing on God. And then I tell you, it's one thing to read the Bible, but it's another thing to experience the Bible. Yeah. You know, His grace is sufficient. Whatever your problem is, and whatever you go through, and whatever's trying to attack you, His grace is sufficient.
Yes.
His grace is sufficient. So we pray for you, Smith. God, come to you right now. Lord, I thank you that your grace is sufficient, Lord. I thank you for your present help in time of trouble. I thank you for every brother and sister we have here, Lord. God, I thank you for everything you're doing in our family and in other families. And Lord, I thank you. Now lift up everybody that's got any kind of problem to you, Lord Jesus. And I ask you just that they can seek refuge under your wing, Lord, and in your word, Lord. And God, I just ask you just